going to quickly to introduce Rolf LAVEN. And you are sort of presenting a paper. It's called Visual Literacy, sorry, and a universal counter question mark.
Yes.
So, Rolf is an artist and professor at the Department for Secondary Schools, Teachers Training College in Vienna. He studied sculpture in Maastricht and Vienna, and he holds a master in visual arts education and also a PhD. He finished in 2004. LAVEN is currently working as a lecturer at the Faculty of Philosophy and Education of the University of Vienna, and also works as a researcher for the European Network of Visual Literacy. In 2013, he received as an award the habilitation grant from the Austrian Ministry of Education. So I hand over the mic to you.
Thank you very much. Good morning, or better to say, I will hold it very short because the time is running and running and running. I'm only one part of the presentation. Professor Wagner from the University of Art from Munich is ill today, so I give the greetings, but I'm alone now. As you can see, the common European framework of reference for visual literacy, there are a lot of people inside. As you see, Julia Kippelmann from Switzerland, Franz Willmeier from the Mozarteum in Salzburg, Ernst Wagner and Constanze Kirchner from the University in Augsburg, Volkert Hanstra from Amsterdam from the University of Art there. The first step, ENVIL, the European Network of Visual Literacy, was founded in 2010, so it's about 5 years old now. It's about 15 members all over Europe, but only over the German-spoken Europe, because all the professors, they are part of this ENVIL group, they all speak German. Most of them all speak German. You see the dark green inside, it's the Middle European country. So Germany is very, very important, and around Germany, the Netherlands, Czechia, Hungary, and Austria, they are working together in the so-called European Network of Visual Literacy. We got a grant from the European Commission in 2014, about 450,000 euros. And work in cooperation with the INSEA. And our task was to develop a prototype for a common European framework of reference for visual literacy. As you can see, here are the centers of this network. It's the University of Flensburg, the University of Amsterdam, Utrecht, Augsburg and Munich, Salzburg and Vienna, Pilsen and Prague, Budapest, and as you can see in the west, we also got France and Switzerland, but they are not joining the project. They are just in brackets, elevating the project. It's the Sorbonne in Paris, and it's the Pädagogische Hochschule in Zurich. The first step was this question of a Serbian artist now living in Croatia, in Zagreb. An artist who cannot speak English is no artist. Written in English, and for us it was the first approach to find this different translation problems. You can see here some translations of different, very important names, like in Dutch, otherwise it's translated in English to instruction, in German to Unterweisung, Obfuding, translated to education, in German to Erziehung, Forming, self-formation, Bildung. We used the CFRL for literacy as a blueprint. It was our first step to it. The concept of competences in art education we wanted to prove. Our research design and the first results will be a competency model I will show you later. Then a survey about the curriculum and implementation in Europe. Also the situations of application. And at last, a big, big glossary. First, the Common European Framework of Referencing for Languages was used as the blueprint was founded in 1971 of a group of experts and was published in 2000 and 2001. As you can see, they worked 30 years at this project. We now work about 5 years, 3 years, 2 years at the center. The background. The first step was to find the comparison of European visual arts curricula. The first step of ANVIL was a survey of visual art curricula and competency models in a sample of 15 European countries. Experts were asked to fill in a questionnaire what competences dimensions are distinguished and what competency levels are defined. We also asked about policy, context, pedagogical, didactic foundations, etc. The results were used to come to a very first sketch of a common structural model. After offering a working definition of competencies, we will provide the first analysis of objective-related guidelines. The concept of competencies will be discussed within the framework of educational research. Let's talk about the framework. We try to systemize measurable ability elements and competencies that are important for all aspects of visual art education. The focus of the element of the research was one of the dimensions of ANVIL is to build a system of visual abilities that will be established after repeated iteration to map and categorize those skills components or competences that are necessary for children or youth activities in art education. The concept of competencies also include domain-specific dimensions which are not derived from daily life context. The part will give the first insight into these dimensions as part of the common European framework. As you can see in the common in the framework of literacy, a student should be able to use languages for communicative purposes. Competencies of a student must develop to be a successful communicator means to master day-to-day situations, to exchange ideas, to share feelings, to develop an understanding of how other people think. They are described as knowledge and skills in a six-step scale. We have to try to transform it to our competency model for visual literacy. You all know the level system A1 to C2. I have to shorten it a little bit. The Common European Framework of Visual Literacy is based on the concept of competencies, change of paradigms from input to output. It was the normal circle we got, now we arrange it with this black box, because nowadays the only references we got is the teacher's own experience. Now we will gain these competencies and look to the outcomes. And you will see that will be a qualitative change. problem was to define the competencies. Disposals that enable students to solve problems, competencies embrace that what students should know, understand, and be able to carry out. Competencies can be acquired in a specific subject. So, our results, or the results of this research work, should be a tool for developers of curricula, for authors of teaching materials, like school books, for teachers designing courses, for students planning their own learning. Therefore, it describes all relevant dimensions of competencies for any kind of pictures, objects, buildings, and images in art, design, and everyday life. It's orientated towards situation. We see visual literacy as a set of skills to master specific situations. So, I have to go on and to on. Little pecha kucha now. It was the questionnaire we sent to the professors all over Europe. And so, this is an overview of the first coming back, Germany reform. It's not the European Song Contest, it's something else. There were some problems. Maybe you see here the range of the ages. Also, what we found was the obligatory lessons of the 8, 12, and 16 year old children or youth. If they are 8, it's in the average, it's 2 hours. If they are 12, it's only 1 or 2. And it's really not clear if they are 16, because most of them, they have no art in their classes, in their lesson subject. So it was a question mark. Another big question was, what is the diverse reference fields for the subject? Fine arts was mentioned the most, architecture also very often, media, everyday picture not so often, design and fashion is weaker and weaker and weaker and weaker. We're always talking about reception and production, and those are our first aim. So I have to go on. We work with different models. It was our first model, that's our second, and this is not our second, our third. We can't talk about the situations now. I have just to show. I have to go to 50, so we will need. That's the glossary we spoke to. I'm ready, I know. The question is always a technical problem. I can't go so quick as I wanted to have the glossary, the Obadja panel, something else. Because I did this presentation in Obadja, I think 1 month ago, and a colleague of mine, Professor Thomas Banchet, he made this artwork of this presentation. But what I wanted to show you is the last one. This is our model, and we will talk about this model then in the group later after the coffee break. Thank you very much.